Yeah, Indians, niggas, same thing.
Yep.
AV, line them up.
I'm a wild Indian, you know I go crazy. Ain't really Indian, that boy for Gazy. I just keep it player, you can never play me. You got an ass so fat, girl, let's make a baby. And another one. Then I'm back to the trap, I'm trying to dub a song. She a bad woke chick, and I love her tongue. We some jurisdiction boys, we some one-on-ones. Look, don't compare me to no Martin dog, I'm like Malcolm X. Die by our freedom, we'll leave a crack and stretch. Round of applause, boy, you know we clapping text. Chucky dog, child's play, yeah, nigga, that's what's next. Open up the cans just like Arizona. Pull up masked up like we got the Rona. We set up jurisdictions when we bought a Kona. How you claiming that's your hood and you not the owner? B to B, I just pulled up in the Need for Speed. Free the land, tell the colonizers that they need to leave. Wild Indian up in my veins, you know how we bleed. You ain't gotta lie about who we is, dog, just keep it G. We at war, we can't keep the peace. Since we at war, gotta keep the peace. Whack a cone, then I meditate. Should I need to breathe? Keep a Omec head when we slide, dog, cause we the sheep.
Like my nigga said, bitch, we the sheep. I can't keep the peace. If it pop off, then I want a piece. I'm just on release. I'm in go mode, motherfucker thief. In these streets like EBT, when we at war, make peace with me. I don't give a damn, understand. Fuck who stole this land. White or black or tan, understand. It's fuck who stole this land. Might have seen me get a little buddy these hands. It wasn't no Abo man. A lot of these dudes is Sambo man. They full of shit like my ammo can. What they call an N word out the wrong mouth as an ambulance. Wild Indian, get it in advance. Or you can post date it. Ask around. I'm the most hated, straight sacred, they stole acres. Yo, ape shit, show ain't shit, it won't be televised, I don't tape shit.
B to B, I just pulled up in the Need for Speed. Free the land, tell the colonizers that they need to leave. Wild Indian up in my veins, you know how we bleed. You ain't gotta lie about who we is, dog, just keep it G. We at war, we can't keep the peace. Since we at war, gotta keep the peace. Whack a cone, then I meditate. Should I need to breathe? Keep a Omec head when we slide, dog, cause we the sheep.
Lil bro. Lil bro done pulled up. Yeah. Man, what up, boy?
What's up, my boy?
Come on, man. Let's hey. Hey.
$1 bill, 1 quarter, and 2 pennies. How much money does he have? Jayden broke.
How y'all doing?
25. That's all I'm asking. If you gonna speed, I give you 5 over. Maybe a little bit closer to 10, but please don't do no more than that, okay?
Okay, we're sorry.
The last thing I need is a kid to run out or y'all to get hit. I do not want to do an accident report for one of y'all. All right?
Yes, sir.
What you tell us?
I'm S-M-A-R-T, that's me. Now me, I know how to write and read. You can't hear me. In a T-H-I.
Okay.
I'm S-M-A-R-T.
she got it. Yeah, they were designer, but tell me, what is the GPA? I'm just being real, and I'm hoping that you don't feel away. My goal as a mother is to make sure that my daughter's straight.
My mama is the best. She set me up for success.
Oh, dang.
The five things that if you're not black, to walk up and say to a black person.
You got me fucked up.
Fuck you, what?
What's taking so long?
Taking so long for what, man? God damn.
Why you playing with me?
Keep on. I don't know what the fuck going on with you, but you keep on.
You got to the count of 10 then.
Count of 10, he's nuts.
Who you talking to?
Yo ass motherfucker! You!
Okay, cut it off.
I asked him if he would let me sing.
I have to get your shoes on. We gotta go fight this girl. I gotta fight her mama, and I'm afraid her little girl's gonna try to beat me up. Will you beat her little girl up? All right, come on, get your shoes on, let's go. Are you practicing? Are you warming up? Show me what you got.
Bitch, I'm outside on my front porch waiting for a nigga who just said that he wants smoke. Okay. I make niggas laugh, but I'm no joke. Beat a nigga ass with my Crocs and sport mode. I feel like Austin Powers with this mojo. 1994, I was born in a war zone. My mama fuck my daddy, what she don't know. That nigga ain't shit, so her ass went so low.
Do you have any idea who shot Shug?
I'm pretty sure Shug knows who shot Shug.
Yeah. Well, I mean,
so when he comes out of sedation, I'm sure anybody who gets shot will tell you who shot them, right?
Yeah.
But if the police say nobody shot him, I believe nobody shot him. And if nobody shot him, that's the same nobody that shot Tupac. And if nobody shot Tupac, it's the same nobody that shot MLK. And if nobody shot him, that's the same person that shot Malcolm X too. It's a lot of nobodies out there, and nobody minds if nobody comes up missing, right? That don't bother nobody, does it?
They told you what at school? That if you're being bullied, what?
You can't go home and tell your parents.
Why?
It could cause the parents to go to the school with with weapons, and it'll end up with someone with their life gone, taken away.
So this is what they're telling y'all in middle school. To not go home and tell your parents that you're being bullied. Right? That's what they're telling you?
Yeah. And self-control.
Self-control. Okay.
All I got out there. That's all I got out there. That's all I got out there. I'm gonna make it.
There goes Fraser.
I can get whatever I want from my mama. That is my mama.
To a certain extent, motherfucker. Now,
I can get whatever I want from my mama.
No, to a certain extent, you a grown ass man. I have to help you out, but I ain't finna just give you every damn
thing.
That's
my mama. I can get whatever I want.
Okay, keep thinking that shit.
Well, hello there. One of my favorite things to do is call white people Negroes to their face. For instance, I was at a restaurant and I go up to a white server and I say, "Excuse me, Negro, do you know where the bathroom is?" They look around. No black people are in sight, so I must be talking to them. They look at me in bewilderment, in confusion. They think to themselves, aren't they the Negro? I looked at him and I said, "Did you hear me, boy?" His eyes widen. He's aghast. The roles have turned and he doesn't know how to handle this. His mouth tremors as he turns and points his finger toward the bathroom and says, "It's over there." I smile at him and I take a quarter out of my pocket and I give it to him. "Why don't you go down there to that Negro child on the street and buy you some lemonade," I say. I used the bathroom, I came out, and I left the restaurant, smiling happily.
Hey, I want y'all to see something real quick. Y'all see that shit? Hold on, let them see this. Y'all see this shit? Y'all see this shit? Do y'all see this shit? Yeah, bro. Do y'all see this shit? Do y'all see this shit? And it's still going. Do y'all see this shit? That shit suspicious as fuck,
bro. They're everywhere. They're fucking everywhere. They're everywhere. I just need y'all to see how everywhere they is.
Hey, bitch, what up? They say they on their clock, it's time to slide. Fuck them up. Hey, look, bro, walking up, masked up, suited up.
Why you lacking?
Lacking? What you mean, bro?
Like, oh, you know where you at right now? Like, bro, I need to take everything off you, bro. Like,
I'm outside Dolly. You know Mabu's body, bro.
Yo, Mabu, like, what you got on you? Like, oh, he got the now.
A grand jury just decided not to prosecute the woman who had Emmett Till murdered, and I'll tell you exactly why they didn't fucking do it. It was because they see their grandma in her, and they always justify it and brush her under the fucking rug because they're like, that was my mom, that was my dad, that was my grandma. That's just how they were back then. But yet they're the same fucking ones who say when you commit the crime, you do the fucking time. And this is why they don't want to teach CRT or any other fucking educational real history in America, because they don't want to be held accountable for their fucking actions. And it doesn't matter how black people protest, how they speak, or whatever the fuck they do, it's never the right fucking answer. Cherry pick the Constitution, they cherry pick the Bible, and they cherry pick everybody's fucking lives, and they will always use Christianity as the last resort to be like, well, I'm just a good Christian. They're scared to lose their lifestyle, their religion, and their white race. And yeah, I am white, and you don't gotta fucking remind me, but that does not mean I owe you any fucking loyalty just because I am white to allow you to continue to be the oppressor when the oppressed have never done anything to you in the motherfucking first place. My name is Eric Stone. Dulces.
They're back. Dodging potholes in the city of Buffalo is taking a toll on some local drivers and their cars.
News 4's Angelica Morrison shares the story of one driver whose run-in with a pothole cost him more than $1,000 in damages.
Yo, this pothole shit is crazy out here, like from Buffalo all the way to Niagara County. Like, you feel what I mean? I'm driving down Main the other night. It's a nice, beautiful day. I got the windows down. You know what I mean? I'm cruising. Boom, boom. Like, what the fuck? I thought I hit somebody. So I look down, it's a fucking pothole. So now the shit turned on my AC, knocked all the change out of my ashtray, and my lights was flickering and shit. So try explaining that to the fucking insurance company. So I know Tamika Beat a Bitch Johnson on Facebook had hit a pothole the other day, knocked all the gas on her car. She had to get two fiends to push her car to the gas station, and she had to pay them $15. Like, who about to keep going through this over these potholes? Something need to happen. Like, these potholes need to get fixed. Like, we over it, man. We over it.
First of all, let's speak about this. Let's speak about this. Marvel wouldn't be shit if it wasn't for a black man named Wesley Snipes, Blade. Marvel wouldn't be shit if it wasn't for a black man saving their motherfucking ass. DC? DC gonna be DC regardless.
Okay, TikTok. I'm coming out here because my mom called me downstairs and she wanted me to look at this cloud. She said in her 57 years of life, she's never seen the cloud look like this. Hold up. She said they look weird, and she's never seen them look like this. She said, I've been here 57 years, Kyra. I've never seen clouds look like this. Now, when you start hearing it from the elderly, you know it's real. Something's not right. She's hiding, but she's here. She's out here looking in amazement.
Yeah, because they look like giant cotton balls.
Have you ever seen anything like it before?
No, not giant cotton balls.
She also said she remembers that the clouds used to move. So do I. They don't move anymore. Not at all. Pay attention.
Still in there? Yeah, my man, you shot today. Cool.
Yeah, I got to go to a men's conference.
A men's conference? Okay.
You know, I'm a motivational speaker. You know what I mean?
Yeah, you know I know about you. You know, I see you. You read up today.
Yeah,
the color's red. Okay. Okay, cool. I see you, bro.
All right, stay in touch
now. Okay.
Daddy, his hair looks wet.
You guys remember that one time when a group of volunteers in Kansas City, Missouri were trying to feed the homeless, and then the health department and then police showed up and poured bleach all over the food?
The health department is speaking out tonight after it poured bleach on food at a local group's event meant to feed the homeless.
Officials shut down that event yesterday because the group didn't have a permit.
This group actually comes to this park as well as other parks around the city to feed the homeless. Yesterday, they were met by the health department and police.
So, you guys are conducting illegal food service.
Well, we're having a picnic with friends.
We invited the public.
Officers and the health inspectors demanded that we destroy our food.
The health department said the group wasn't following the law about serving the homeless.
They were notified back in September at a meeting that they needed to get a permit.
That's incorrect. We've never had any kind of government official ever come and speak with anybody at any of the public parks.
Inspectors then poured bleach on the food to make sure nobody ate it.
A standard procedure in public health is to go ahead and pour bleach on the food so that people won't consume something that's dangerous.
Despite being shut down, organizers say they will continue to serve.
You guys will continue no matter what.
No matter what.
Got an update on a story that we've been following since last Sunday. That's when the Kansas City Health Department poured bleach on food prepared for the homeless. Today, at the same place, at the same time, volunteers with free hot soup KC handed out food to those in need.
A gathering of friends. 11 minutes. Giving clothes and food to their friends who don't have homes.
It's hot. Be careful, okay?
That's how Free Hot Soup Kansas City describes itself. A description they've doubled down on ever since the health department told them they couldn't serve food to the homeless without a permit.
We had a lot of anxiety coming into today. You know, was the health department going to show back up? Are the police going to be here? You know, are people going to get to eat?
This week, Free Hot Soup had help on standby. Attorney Amy Bell, who argues they're protected by these words written in stone next to the park.
It's our right of freedom of association and freedom of speech. And for many people here, it's a freedom of religion issue, that their religion dictates that they come and share their food and help the needy.
But the group also made some changes this week, handing out mostly pre-packaged food.
A lot of non-healthy stuff, nothing that really warms the belly, warms the soul, not stuff we're used to bringing, which is a little disheartening.
Jackie Richardson is one of the people Free Hot Soup serves. He's been homeless for 2 years.
All week was a hard week for me because I didn't have any food I usually get from over here at the park.
For Richardson, it was a relief to see familiar faces handing out help he has come to rely on. Reporting in Kansas City.
I think they're angels.
Only
you
in
gotta
Chicago.
Say, goof fast.
Goof fast.
No, yo, goof fast.
Goof fast.
No, get your goof fast.
Get your goof
off. And introduce yourself. You know what I'm saying? I know y'all don't know each other, but what's your real name?
D'Arius.
Okay, what's your name?
Tatiana.
Tatiana.
I heard of a few Tatianas. Mm-hmm, and I don't
but
like
I'm
Tatiana.
One of a kind, baby, so don't do that.
Ooh, period, period, period. All right, so boom, boom, boom. So, but basically, both of you guys.
I heard that before, too.
No, you hear a lot of things because you got ears.
Ooh.
Ooh. Is this a date or a.
Is this
a blind date or y'all finna fight? You wanna feel each other out or what?
All right, chill. All right, so obviously, both of you guys came together looking for love, right?
Right. Mm. I mean, I'm looking for a little
I'm
bit of love.
I'm looking for something to fuck. You know, to be honest. No, I ain't really looking for no love. I'm just looking for something just to do.
Okay.
And hit me later. That's it.
Sit
That's
back.
All.
Sit
if
back.
That's the case, we ain't got to do the blind date.
No. Don't take that off. You know what I'm saying? Cool. All right, so I was wrong about the love thing, but you know what I'm saying? We just going to figure it out. Mm-hmm. All right, so I'm going to ask you the question first.
Me?
Yes.
Okay.
What is your type?
You know, it's all over the place. I like them, you know what I'm saying? Black, white, nah. All right, black, light, Mexican, Dominican, Puerto Rican.
Oh, you like them all?
Small, tall,
I don't
big,
got no type.
Small.
Okay.
You know
cool.
what I'm saying?
So you really don't got a type like
right,
that?
Right, right,
just
right.
Just as long as they love you.
Right, long as they love me, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Right.
All right, what about you? What's your type?
I really don't have no type. It's your personality for me. Like, I gotta know what you are, how you doing, when you doing, like, how you are as a person. Like, you could be ugly as hell, but your personality could be the shit.
True enough.
I'm looking for a nigga with a big ass dick, nice little body, you know, he got that little, he got some little shmonies.
Okay.
But at the same time, his personality.
Okay.
Ooh.
All right. So, real, hey bro, you gotta chill. She can't even see you.
Nice little bodies, big zick, and some monies, right?
Mm-hmm.
My wallet back.
Nothing. Back. No money. You digging in your wallet. Oh, okay. Oh, you do got the money.
Let me put it on her right now.
You finna put the money on her?
I'm finna put it on her for later after this date, because I'm liking what I'm sounding. I'm like what I'm hearing, baby.
Mm, okay.
All right. Chill. No, chill.
Right on. Okay, I like how you feel too. You're feeling all soft.
Cause I am.
All right. Cool.
Make my body jitter. I like this day.
All right. Okay. So I'm gonna start with you, Tati.
Mm-hmm.
Matter of fact, what's your favorite color?
Oh, I like blue, green, orange, and yellow. Bless you. Bless you.
Cool.
Okay. And Darius, what's your favorite color?
Pink and blue.
Just pink and blue. Okay, cool. Now, this question may pull you guys away from each other. Do you have kids, Tati?
Hell no.
No kids? You don't like kids?
No, I'm the best stepmama to ever have, but goddamn, I don't want no kids of my own. No.
Okay, so you like
I love other people's kids, yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Darius.
Hmm?
Do you got any kids?
Hmm?
Do you have any kids?
Of my own?
Yeah.
They're not with me right now.
Do you have any kids?
At home.
How many?
Two.
Okay. Mm. So you got two kids.
They ain't running you away, is it, Shawty?
Nah.
Alright.
Okay.
Still got her.
All right. So Darius.
Yes.
What do you like to do in your free time?
I got 5 guns. I like to go shooting. Mm-hmm. I like to go play basketball.
Baller.
Do a little fishing there now and then.
Mm-hmm.
And have fun with my kids.
Okay. What about you, Tati?
I like to smoke. I smoke a lot of weed. I like to work. I be cooking on my free time. I like to write, write my little poem.
You a poet?
I'm a nigga poet, something like that. And then I like to have my nieces and nephews sometimes when they ain't begging.
Mm-hmm. When they ain't begging?
Yeah.
What they be begging for?
Snacks, money, whatever kid wants. It's just, no, we not doing that. They just be ODing it. That's it.
Period. Mm-hmm. Okay, so at this point, you know what I'm saying? I'm going to give you, Tatiana, I'm going to give you a 5-second touch test.
Teslas can see ghosts.
I got my Tesla a few weeks ago, maybe 2 weeks to be exact. And I'm having second thoughts. Not because it's not a badass car, because it is. It's fast and all this technology. But wait. So I was having some software issues. Went to see the technician. We walked to my car. We got inside. He said, oh yeah, you got all the cameras inside and outside. Have you gone out to the cemetery? I'm saying, no. Why? He said, because they can pick up ghosts and spirits. I'm like, yeah. He said, no, go to YouTube. So I didn't think anything of it, but I did get home. I went to YouTube, and yeah, these people were actually in the cemetery and they saw ghosts. It creeped me the fuck out. So again, didn't think of it. Wednesday morning, woke up frightened. And it dawned on me. Monday, I was headed to the bike shop and I saw an image, and I'll show you in a second what I'm talking about. Walking, and I looked to the side. I was at a stoplight, didn't see anything, and a truck in front of me, car in the back of me. The image appeared again. So I said, where is it? Where is the person? Because I want to make sure they're not approaching me. Nothing. There's another person walking, right? So that's what it shows. It shows you the cars around you, in front of you, whatever. There's not many cars in front of me. Okay, so there's a car coming on the side of me. Okay. That was a fucking ghost or a spirit. And also, there's a cemetery on the same route. I don't know if I had passed it or was approaching it, but that shit creeped me out. I don't want to see ghosts and spirits in this car. No, and Muslims talk about jinns all the time, and some of those jinns are bad. So I don't know. I wonder if there's some kind of way you can turn those images off or whatever. It's creepy.
I was watching a video of a young man where he said, how is it possible for just a handful of these people to capture hundreds and hundreds of us? And it got me to thinking, And I have been thinking about this for days. How is that possible? Imagine you're on a slave ship. You got 400 big, strong, burly men that was captured by 30 or 40 little weaklings. Is it possible that they magnified slavery to make themselves look superior? Is it possible? Because I'm really having a problem with this. Because we as black people, we are fighters. So you mean to tell me all of them against those little couple of men and they just let them do it?
Got an ID on you, sir?
Everybody's got an ID, right? Why would you need that?
Because we're out here for a lawful purpose and I need to identify you.
I ain't breaking any law, sir.
Okay, so you're telling me you're not going to identify yourself?
If you give me a crime that I've committed, I'll be glad to give it to you.
You don't have to commit a crime to identify yourself.
Yeah, you do. In South Carolina,
I have to have a lawful right to make contact.
This is not a stopping ID state, sir.
You have to identify yourself. So, are you refusing to do that?
Hang on. Hang on. Threat of arrest. If you're going to arrest me for not identifying, I will absolutely identify. Because I don't want to get arrested. All right? But if you're telling me, and you said it's lawful to ask me for my ID without breaking a law, then you're totally wrong. But you can push that if you want to.
Oh, I will. Don't worry.
Yeah, I know you will.
Look at this crazy shit, man. Like, for real, bro. She want me to hit her.
No, I just want you to put the refrigerator in the house. We can't lift that thing. We don't even have a dolly.
Okay, we've been having a fly problem out here at my boy's spot where he been grilling and stuff, right? So, I told him to do this old trick I seen on YouTube. Put you some syrup and some hot dogs in a mason jar and poking some holes in it. And then you got yourself a number one fly trap.
I'm going to sign the ticket.
That's all you wanted to do is sign a ticket. That's all it is.
I'm going to sign the ticket.
You told me you're not.
I'm going to sign the ticket. Mr. Brooks, I'm going
you
to sign the ticket.
You don't have that option now.
Why don't I have the option,
because
Mr. Brooks?
Because I gave you two options. She was just asking for your badge number at first.
I'm asking for your badge number, and I wasn't clear on why you weren't giving me your badge.
Sir, you don't have to. Sir, you do not have to hold her like that.
Oh my God.
Sir, you do not have to drag her like that.
I'm going to sign the ticket, Mr. Brooks. I'm going to sign the ticket. Why am I being arrested? Can you please tell me why I'm being arrested?
Sir!
Oh my God! I'm so scared. My God, please, in the name of Jesus, please, God, in the name. Why am I being arrested, Mr. Brooks? I'm going to sign the ticket. Mr. Brooks, why am I being arrested? Why am I being arrested? I don't understand why I'm being arrested. Can you please tell me why I'm being arrested?
Turn around and put your hands behind you.
Tell me why I'm being arrested. Right. I have the right to know. Do not taser her.
What are you tasing her for?
I didn't taser.
Why are you pulling it out?
Put your hands behind your back.
This is not complying.
Hey, Mike. Hey, oh, shit, Mike. Oh, shit. Oh.
When teaching my white husband how to do the Tamia hustle before we go to Detroit.
But I got a little game that I want to play.
about giving myself to you. Cause you know I want you, babe. And I would do anything. And I know you're thinking the same thing, babe.
So come and get it.
Come and get it.
I'm so excited.
I can't have my feelings get it. I won't stop.
I'm the harassing lady, y'all. Every day. Yeah. Yes, ma'am.
You guys still?
I have to check. Yeah.
I hope you're gonna be bringing some on the border. You're supposed to brought back last the week before this last week when you didn't come back. We haven't had any on the border at all. The last week. My sweetie.
Cheese popcorn. Cheese puff
corn. Got that too? Every day. Double cup, stop phone, pull it up. It's a little-
They let this man and his wife foster more than 40 children, including black and brown kids, and yet he was a documented racist who believed in sexually mutilating children painfully. What? Dr. John Harvey Kellogg, brother of Kellogg's founder W.K. Kellogg, unintentionally invented cornflakes in 1894 while creating one of the numerous vegan and vegetarian foods he served at the Battle Creek Sanitarium. His luxury Seventh-day Adventist Medical Center spa and Grand Hotel once welcomed guests Henry Ford, Amelia Earhart, Booker T. Washington, and Sojourner Truth. Patients there could receive various treatments of Harvey's invention, including diet reform, continuous baths lasting for hours to months, water or yogurt enemas, and light therapy. He was obsessed with external and internal cleanliness, or what he called biological living, which included daily exercise, lots of fresh air, and total abstinence from tobacco, caffeine, alcohol, sex, and especially masturbation. He believed masturbation was the cause of many ailments, from poor digestion and impaired vision to heart disease. He encouraged parents to prevent masturbation by binding children at bedtime. If unsuccessful, he recommended unanesthetized circumcision or stitching closed the foreskin with silver wire to prevent erection and carbolic acid to the clitoris. His pursuit of cleanliness also extended to race, with Harvey spending the last 30 years of his life developing the science of eugenics to ensure whites did not intermingle with inferior races.
Right on it.
I'm gonna give y'all an example of subtle racism and stereotypes in marketing. Here you got Caleb. I don't know why I named him Caleb, but he looks like a Caleb to me. But anyway, he's enjoying his barbecue, you know, napkins, a couple pieces of bread, fingers are clean, not a sign of barbecue sauce around his lips. And then we got Jamal. Now, I don't know why Jamal got a whole slab in his hand. And why does he, like, I feel you, Jamal. Like, I feel you. But come on, Pepsi. What the hell, man? Caleb, Jamal.
Y'all, I'm going to try to get as much of this as I can. Without anybody seeing, that is stats. That's one of the mountains of baby formula cans. They have, look at this. And there's thousands of pallets sitting all over there, all behind me. All in front of me. I've got a whole 45,000 pounds of baby formula on...
You get lonely.
Yo, for all my Philly peoples out there, you ain't gonna like to hear this, but Sheetz is better than Wawa. Just keep it real.
I'm placing you under citizen's arrest.
For what?
For parking too close to my car.
Oh, wow, well, I'll just go.
Yeah, just move it. Move.
Oh, no, you don't, princess. Stop filming me!
Doomsday map shows Atlantis and Lemuria are coming back.
Now, I live in Massachusetts, alright? It looks like western part. The western part of this, right? I can't zoom in for some reason. But looks like a little bit of this is safe. Florida, central Florida pretty much is safe. But anybody notice Atlantis? Now, I saw this on a video. But check this out. Lemuria. Now, I just switched to a regular map, right? You don't see Atlantis at all. Now, look at, you don't even see Lemuria at all, right? Now, this is the ancient map, right? Now, this is North America. This is supposed to be Lemuria. That's crazy, because that's exactly where they're saying that Lemuria was. Here's another picture of Lemuria. North America, South America, wild. This is an actual relic from Lemuria. Wow. Shows North America, South America. This is a map.
What were you gonna do with my little brother?
That was it.
Sex with my little brother, huh? With my little brother? You were gonna have sex with my little brother, who's a minor. What the fuck made you think that was all right, huh? Huh?
No, it shouldn't be all
right. Answer the fucking question. Don't shake your head. You answer a question when I ask it. You got protection on you, don't you? Don't you?
Yeah.
Let me see it. Open it up. What the hell are you out here trying to f*** a little kid for, dude? All right, let's go.
All right, let's go, bro.
Call the police.
Call the police right now, dude.
Call them. I ain't letting you go, bro. No, you got an issue, don't you?
You know what's funny? I know exactly who this guy is.
Yeah, he works at Publix. What'd you say?
Oh, you're a predator, dude. You want to meet little kids, man.
What'd you say you were going to do? You want to meet with a little kid to ask? You're doing?
You want to meet a little fucking kid
and
have sex with your 15-year-old bro?
There they come. Hey, they're right here. Stop. He's here to meet a child relations.
He's trying to meet up with a 15-year-old relations. He has condoms in his pocket, you know? Right. He showed me the condoms, everything like that.
This is for the silly people who don't know that there were so-called black folks on currency in the United States, all right? And before you go, oh, they were slaves, let me just tell you something about so-called slaves, right? First of all, you don't see no chains on these folks. Second of all, when you call sharecroppers, a lot of them owned that land and was cheated out of it by banks. Third of all, a lot of so-called slaves bought their own freedom after working and getting what? Paid. So you know what that means? They had a bad contract. Now where your folks land at? And where y'all on the coins?
I don't do none of that shit. I be rapping. I just be capping. I just be rapping. I don't want smoke with a motherfucking soul. I ain't in the streets, bitch. I don't get active. Fuck you for me. I ain't got ops. Little niggas stop. You niggas can have it. I ain't no drug lord. Never seen a brick or bust open a motherfucking package. I don't do no crime, nigga. No lie. To be real with you, nigga. niggas, I'm average. Run a small business, I don't sell drugs. To be honest, I'm pretty established. We doing jungle moves, selling sea moss. That's the way that I'm making this cable. I don't know what the fuck niggas talking. Tell them free 30 and RP Saber.
I'm from a good home and some good parents. Private school, I could've went to college. I ain't go to feds for selling drugs or no guns. I was stealing from Tops. And it's a committed relationship with my fiance. I'm lying when I say that I'm hot. Ain't never space shit, ain't never call up a hit or put nothing on no nigga, nah. I ain't got no bags, ain't got no Drake, ain't got no money, nigga, I'm broke. Said I got side bags for a low number, but I ain't gonna lie, man, that shit was a joke. Ain't smoking no more dead niggas in my day, man, I lied, this is regular smoke. I ain't no kingpin, no drug lord, only crust that I sold with some cinnamon toast.
I don't do none of that shit.
If you just laughed at that, I'm putting you on the church prayer list, but we gotta be friends.
That device you see plugged into the iPhone, that's my video transmitter. Now this is my video repeater. Basically, it takes any video signal coming out of the iPhone and it boosts it, enhances it, and I can take over any other video signal that I want that I put this close to.
Just one quick question, Your Honor. Is there any way to can that be deferred a little bit? I'm just in a bit of a financial situation, is why.
How much can you pay today?
I have 92 cents in my account. I just walked from East Providence this morning to get over here.
Did you walk from East Providence?
Yes, Your Honor. Roger Williams Ave.
That's 5 miles from here.
Yeah, about an hour and a half. Hour 35.
What is it?
It's about an hour 35. Walking? I'm walking back right now too. Yeah. So.
Yeah, it's a 5 mile walk.
20 minutes, I can do it.
I got my running shoes on, so I'm actually gonna hustle. Yeah, I'm gonna hustle back. It shouldn't take as long as it did on the way here.
Can you take an Uber?
I have no money.
Now, my fund is the Philomena Fund, which is named after my mother. So, Mr. DeMosco, who's unemployed, just this morning sent in $25 in cash.
That's not good for me.
I'm gonna give it to you.
Oh, thank you.
I want you to take an Uber so you don't have to walk back.
I really appreciate that. You don't have to do it. I don't mind. I got to run anyway, to be honest. I couldn't take it, Your Honor. Thank you.
Take it.
I will.
Take it.
All right. Thank you very much. You saved me a great deal of time today, Your Honor, and money.
That's only half the battle, right? That's our part. You have to do your part.
Yes, Your Honor, I will. I won't be getting any more tickets.
I don't care about you coming back here. That's not what I'm talking about. Right? You have to help somebody else.
Yes, Your Honor.
There are an awful lot of people out there who have similar problems, and you are going to be in a situation to help them. Don't forget them.
I should have 3 spaghetti.
You guys treat everybody like this?
Ma'am, we have treated you with utmost respect.
You drugged me through Walmart like I stole, and you said go to the room and give her my ID.
I asked you to come with us
okay.
up to the service.
Well, I'm just being for my protection.
No one is threatening you.
This
no
is the most embarrassing thing ever when you come to Walmart and come here every day and spend hundreds of dollars. I spend hundreds of dollars in the store. A week.
Ma'am, we are trying to do this.
Yes, okay, so finish.
You are free to record. However, you do not need to sit here and give us commentary. 3.
Yeah. I'm not a thief. I'm a Christian.
Said anything about me?
You did, because you pulled me back here like I stole something. This is the most embarrassing thing.
076.
076.
Hooks on there, sprites on there. 2 double sweet cakes. Yeah.
Yep. How many?
2 Folgers instant and TCHB.
How many?
3 of those.
Okay.
And a whipped bread.
Bread?
That's it.
You got the eggs?
Yep.
That's it?
There.
All right. This Can on I? The bottom has not been scanned, ma'am.
No, they were scanned. I did scan them by the gun. I did scan them. She just told you. She's showing you. I scanned them, sir.
Pack.
Apology. Thank you. Thank you.
No, I said everything was scammy.
Thank you. I would like an apology. Can I get an apology?
I misunderstood. And I'm getting a.
Okay, people, right now it's all over everything. Trump's house has been raided by the FBI. That's all you're seeing on the news. That's all you're seeing on social media. Don't get so distracted that we're not watching what the left hand's doing. This is a big distraction. Right, wrong, or indifferent, I'm telling you, there's something else going on. Don't take your eyeballs off of it.
When you want a motorcycle but you're on a budget,
dumb.
I'm trying to keep a look.
What kind of look is this?
Gangsta.
You trying to keep a gangster look?
Yeah.
So you think this is a gangster persona? With these tight ass pants on?
Yeah, I'm thinking.
Your fucking zipper don't even zip.
It's zip.
Matthew, you look a fool.
Oh, now
you need to take that off, seriously. That you don't look cute, you don't look swaggy, it's not a look.
It's just nothing, like you just...
He looks a hot mess.
I got a Burberry belt, it's not nothing.
You got a Burberry belt?
That doesn't level anything that you got going on right here up.
Because the bag is... Watch your back before you get hit by the bus. So because you got a Supreme bag and a what you said, that kind of belt?
Burberry belt.
A Burberry belt. Is this swaggy?
I think.
No, you look a hot mess.
Where is
it? What was his name? Get out of there.
What the fuck? Bruh! Oh my...
The most incredible thing I've ever seen. This is a trunk and tree grew all the way through the stop sign. How amazing it is. Crazy, it's unbelievable.
Grand jury declines to indict the white woman whose accusation set off the lynching of Emmett Till. The Chicago teenager was killed nearly 7 decades ago. Earlier this year, an unserved arrest warrant for Carolyn Bryant Donham was found inside a Mississippi courthouse. A grand jury was asked to consider the warrant and Donham's newly revealed memoir about Till's kidnapping and also death. After hearing more than 7 hours of testimony from investigators and witnesses, the grand jury determined that there was just not enough sufficient evidence to indict Donham. Till's family says today's announcement is, quote, unfortunate but predictable.
Welcome to you.
Show you how what's tactical turkeys doing.
I'm from West Point, Mississippi, born and raised. On the playground was where I spent most of my days. I was chilling out, maxing and relaxing, all cool, and I was shooting some b-ball outside of school. When a couple of guys, like, they were up to no good, right? Started making trouble in the neighborhood. I got in one little fight. My mom got scared and said, you know, you're moving with your auntie and uncle in Bel Air. I didn't want to go.
You ain't gonna grab his shoulder.
Get that shit! Ah, get that shit!
Went to my first rodeo this weekend in Conyers, Georgia, and not just any old one, the Bill Pickett All Black Traveling Rodeo. We are walking into the Black Rodeo, the Bill Pickett Rodeo, and I'm ready to see what is going on and what this means. If you watch The Harder They Fall on Netflix, Edie Cathiji's character was Bill Pickett, the real-life black cowboy known as the father of bull riding. This rodeo honors him and all the past and current black cowboys and cowgirls. What an experience this was. The black folks all dressed up, the gorgeous horses. Sit back and enjoy the greatest show on dirt.
All that rebirth is gonna win. All the people that live in sin. They're the coming, you're gonna lie. So get the beauty, you ring a fire.
Cowboys helped shape the American West, and reclamation of that narrative is essential to understanding the great migration of black folks and how cowboy culture landed in places like Philly, LA, and Oklahoma. Events like these remind us who we are. This might have been my first rodeo, but it's not my last.
So this is one of my chores I have to do about every 2 weeks during the summer. I get water about every 10 to 14 days. So I have to go to the main ditch when it's my turn and block the water from going down further on the ditch. And that will block it up and raise the water level to where I can run it through my own ditch. So I've got to put some boards in that will block the water. And then I'll go ahead and open my main head gates when I get all those set. So it's kind of sketchy. That board I'm walking on is probably 40 years old and it's starting to rot out a little bit. And same with this one. But open the head gate. It's been here for a while. It's kind of rusty, kind of hard to get open. And that will let the water run down into my section of the ditch. So once the water's in there, I go ahead and watch to make sure it's flowing good. Walk down as it goes through the ditch. This sometimes takes a little bit depending on how much water flow I have. We're getting towards the end of summer and the water is a little bit lower, so it takes a little bit longer to fill the ditch and water, but it'll still get done. So these are removable tarp dams that you fill up with water. It keeps water from going down further. And then I could pull a head gate out, and that will let water flow down into my pasture area. And after about, this first zone takes about 8 hours, but after about an hour, it looks like this. And it will go all the way back to my 7 acres back there and water it.
And I just brought in some ears, little bitches, the first of the month. Ryan, run, I'm in the game, little bitch, I'm a chair of the city, I'm afraid of the sun. I went and paid in the bins, I switched shit up, I wanted it, nobody done. Hold on, my face, my family, my coat, my brother, my slime, my sister, my mom.
Part 2. Police chase.
Oh, he's going through the yard. Oh my God. He's going through the yard.
I knew he was going through the yard.
He's right
there. What the heck? This is...
Good. What can I do for you?
Well, I didn't know if this is brand new in the box, and I didn't know if it was,
okay.
Yeah, you could take this off, and then you could see, I didn't even want to take it out of the inside box. So if you
want, I see there's a box and a box.
In a box. Okay. So I didn't mess with it any further. So if you want.
All right, I'll flip it around. We'll check it out.
Okay, thanks. And my intention would be to come back and buy it back from you.
Okay. Well, it's open on this side.
Oh, see, I didn't see that because I didn't open it. I didn't want to mess with it.
Let's see. And we got newspaper.
What the heck? Oh, my God.
Well, better newspaper than bricks.
Well, that's really interesting. Okay.
Stupid bitch, had me up in that motherfucking shame of arguing with that man behind a motherfucking strip fire right plate. Stupid asshole. You know what,
I did order that.
You're a motherfucking liar. The man said.
I did
stupid
order.
Bitch. Get out my face. Get out my face.
They must have got it wrong, bro.
No,
I swear to God,
no.
I ordered you a plate, bro. You know I wouldn't do that to you, man. You thought I would have made you go in there and
you
all that rain?
You fucking lying. You fucking lying.
So what you
said?
Something.
I said, the number, he said, all right. I said, shrimp for manners. I said, yeah, and another shrimp for our plate. No. I said, yes, they got a shrimp for our plate. Whatever the fuck, she was a smile. See, you made me look an ass up in it. It's not fucking funny, bitch.
I thought I did, Arthur.
You know you fucking did.
I thought I did.
Don't talk to me. Get out of my face.
So you mad? You want some of my noodles?
On the motherfucking noodles.
Just a question, man.
Yeah, well, I get that. And so then my only question to you is your name, just so it's okay in my own heart and mind. And when I say the season we're living in, you know the season we're living in.
Y'all looking for something over here at his house?
What is it?
Y'all concerned about something over here at this house?
This house?
No, that house.
Yes.
What's the problem?
Who lives there?
Mr. Ferguson? He's probably there now. He's 79.
Okay. All right. What's your name, sir?
Jason Tart.
Jason Tart?
Tart.
And what do you mean by the season we're living in, ma'am?
Sir.
What do you need? You got any questions for me?
No, I'll collect some information from you in a minute. Your name and date of birth and such.
What do you need my information for?
You own these two homes, correct? Okay, these two homes is near that marijuana grow, so I'd just like to have your name.
You know how many people go through here?
I understand.
That's not going to do you one bit of good.
Okay. Well, sir, I'm going to need your name and date of birth. And I have that.
I feel comfortable giving you my name and date of birth.
Okay, well, this is a criminal investigation. You own these two homes, so by law, you do have to give me your name and date of birth, sir.
If he gives you a reason, yes, you do.
Reason for what?
Because of the marijuana grow.
It's not on my property.
Okay, well, again, I have reason to believe that these two homes here that you own is related to that marijuana grow. So you have to give me your name and date of birth by law. Go get a pen and piece of paper.
Reason to believe what? Why? Because these houses are here?
Yes, sir, and you own them.
May I say something?
Right. Do you understand? I was born and raised here. Do you understand that there are a lot of traffic going through here?
Since we lived here, people come up here and they park there, and we don't know where the hell they go, and then they come back out.
I don't have a problem giving you my information.
Okay, well, that's all I need. It doesn't have to be an argument. I mean, just give me your name and date of birth, Dave. It's easy.
It's not easy. My property has nothing to do with what you found.
Okay. Well, we're just making sure of that. That's our job.
Berwyn Land Company owns.
Sir, I don't understand why you're being argumentative about giving me your name and date of birth.
I'm not.
It's simple.
Well, you scared me. I mean,
scared you.
Says that.
By asking you a question?
Who comes up and asks? That's crazy.
And it scared you?
I'm trying to understand what
it scared you by me asking you a question.
Growing marijuana?
And that's a question.
What does these houses on my property got? Did you find it on my property?
It's near your property.
Yeah.
Woke up this morning and wonder, hey, should I get fresh or should I keep it humble? My closet like Dover Street used to be bumming. Some days I'm still bumming. The difference is now it's by choice. Got just a peek out the window. These little niggas different. They don't play Nintendo. They play with extendos. I hope you can limbo. That chopper gon' spin you around like a judge on a voice. I'm from a city where most niggas never get lucky enough to see something outside county limits. I ran up the digits. I don't have no motherfucking business. Complain about nothing. Ain't got no time and no patience for lists they be making or who they debating is better. Let's face it, he one of the greatest. No Bill Cosby shit, but if niggas is sleeping, then fuck him.
Another tall crop we got here in California. I'd like to thank all of our neighboring states for letting us have all that water. I know you guys need it, but we need it more.
So now's where you really make your savings. Okay? All of this stuff here, all this pre-packaged, pre-made, do it yourself. You can get it done quick. Don't do it. This is where you hear all the complaints about all the extra additives and preservatives, all the ingredients that's killing us. Welcome to it. Here it is. Now, on the other hand, this is your safe zone. But you have to do it from scratch. You got your cornbread here. You got your flour. All types of meals and all types of flour. Baking powder, baking soda. This is how you bake. This is what you need.
Why? Why? I'm fucking pissed. Why? What the this is for all you just comply motherfuckers. Watch this.
A very important story that you need to see. Colorado police under fire for taking a woman and four clearly unarmed children, the youngest is 6 years old, and holding them in custody, often at gunpoint, forcing them to lie, cuffed face down, as you see here on the ground, scared and humiliated. This was in a salon parking lot for upwards of 2 hours. That is hard to watch, even for a few seconds. Imagine living through it. That went on, as I mentioned, for upwards of 2 hours. This is America. This happens all the time. Most of the time, I'll be honest with you, it's not even on the national news. Now tonight, what's new is the woman you saw there, her name is Brittany Gilliam, is now suing Aurora, Colorado. She alleges in court that entire spectacle was an invalid and illegal arrest. She alleges the police were breaking the law. She also notes in her new suit that it hurt and traumatized those innocent children. You heard their cries. She says they now struggle with basic activities like eating and sleeping, and they're in therapy for this. The police department, to be clear, is not even claiming they had an accurate reason for the arrest and conduct you see there by the officers. Instead, they do apologize And they say they incorrectly thought that that vehicle was stolen. It wasn't. An explanation that many law enforcement experts say does not even justify the force and guns drawn that you saw.
This is almost halfway up the door.
What the fuck is that red spot in the sky? Okay, all right. Everybody out here like, the fuck? Does anybody else see it? Yeah, we see it. What the fuck is that? What the fuck is that?
The moment you realize it's people that you love that you gon' have to leave behind. I was told, wow, look, we at war. Everybody can't go though. Some of us vibing high. Everybody can't go though. Some of y'all might leave family behind. Everybody can't go though. Could've completed, but you get deleted. Some people are feeded, so you feel deleted. And knowledge is medicine, knowing you need it. If everyone go, I'ma know that you cheated. You think I'm conceited, I'm feeling completed. Life is a game and I'm planning to beat it. Life is a game and I'm planning to beat it. Everybody can't go though, beat it. You was ascending and starting to win. No pretending, actually win. Low vibrations boxing you in. Who keep letting them toxins in? All my people are toxin us. Everyone on our toxin land. Ancient like cosmology. I am the source, I go within. I can't go unless I go to win. Really a god supposed to win. Anyone that's trying to get with me, just start doing the most you in. Trying to turn up, it goes to 10. Blood type O, you almost in. Menarchin, we all go in. G, I'm a rule, we all go in. Bring you the water, but can't make you drink. No, I'm not here to just make you think. If anything, I'm here to just make you fight. It's all lost, just make it right. Everybody ain't with it. Let me tell you, I don't like reading. Freedom ain't free, you broke, I get it. Let me tell you, don't like breathing. Can't even wake you up, you sleeping. Niggas are sleeping, scalping season. Some of y'all sleep through all this treason. Government beefing, now you vegan. Need autonomy, really don't need them. Now we rise, cause house is freedom. Really gon' hurt my heart to leave them. Really gon' hurt my heart. This assimilation or a cycle, they be hating on you for survival. That's why I don't mess with the Bible. Ain't nobody tribal going viral. We original, we hold the title. Lot of work to do, how you idle. Ain't no false idols in they bio. We ancient, for ancient in Ohio. Say what you want and do what you do, but I'm starting to get it, I don't know about you. Gotta go within, can't go on YouTube. If you think you know, you ain't got no clue. Say what you want and do what you do, but I'm starting to get it, I don't know if you do. Gotta go within, can't go on YouTube. You thinking you know, you ain't got no clue. We at war. Everybody can't go though. Some of us vibing high. Everybody can't go though. Some of y'all might leave family behind. Everybody can't go though. Could've completed, but you get deleted. Some people are feeded, so you feel deleted. And knowledge is medicine, knowing you need it. If everyone go, I'ma know that you cheat.